The newly created district of Kasanda has started in financial mess with over 600 million shillings of public funds unaccounted for. The district constituted a public accounts committee that investigated the matter and recommended recovery.
What made almost 600 million shillings was the double payment of gratuity and the pension. People were double paid. The report came out showing that a lot of money was mishandled and we intervened. After the work done by the Public Accounts Committee, the district one, then DEC had to sit on it and add on some comments.
Part of this money went missing through double payments of pension and gratuity, overpayment of salaries and procurement laws. In one case, 27 employees were overpaid 15.2 million shillings in salaries, while 561 employees were paid on wrong bands, which led to overpayment of 7.7 million shillings.
We have others, it's about failure to follow procurement process, because there is a procedure. If you want to procure things for the government, you should follow procurement process. Others, I think... But most of the recommendations, they made recommendations that those funds should be recovered from the officers complicated in the report.
The Auditor General's report also highlighted that five individuals forged minutes of the Education Service Commission and were regularly recruited and paid 35.6 million shillings. When the Deputy IGG, Andrew Nomugesha Muhaire, visited the district, councillors demanded for a serious action on implicated officers who are well known in the district.
Kasanda, ndabye ba members ba staff abava mu office ya IGG. Nendo waza mbaje Kasanda wa shaping ba officials wa districts oba local governments engerije ba yinzo kulyoburunje sente za government. Kubanga we have been seeing officials from IGG's office in Kasanda.
Did is that these people should pay, and most of them should be dismissed from the work, because I think about a CFO, Chief Finance Officer, to be involved in such a saga.
The audit report also revealed that 10.6 million shillings was paid to eight staff who had either retired, transferred, absconded, or died with average delays of 3 to 4 months, hence causing government financial losses. The district chairperson, Kasiria Zimula, noted that loss of these funds was occasioned by public servants who abused their offices to conduct government work in a haphazard manner.
I think because this is a new district, people still think that we have no district. That was the behavior from Mubende, where we came from, because remember this district was carved from Mubende district. And we've been in an interim government where councillors sit together and decide who is going to lead them for the last 3 years. I'm the first elected chairperson, and I found almost everything in shambles.
The Deputy IGG Muhaire tasked the district chief executive officer to furnish her with proper information in order to swing into action. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.